chopping regular corn today. We're taking a break from the airlage. Got the 8600 with the 8-row Kemper, 9700 with the 10-row Kemper, and then we got our 990 with the Orbis. It's the old style Orbis, so 12-row. The field's a little grassy, so we're gonna see how it does. Might have to pull it off. Last time we were in real grassy stuff, it started plugging up. I guess we're gonna find out, huh? Here to chop corn and try to turn the knives on the 8600 and it's throwing a bunch of codes. So we come over here,
accumulator right here, the bracket broke and it had fell down in between the cabinet and the frame and it had squished the controller, the module. I'm not sure what you want to call it. So we have a new one coming out right now. So if you guys have this this chopper, make sure to check this bracket. Keep an eye on it.
Grass earlier is actually pretty good, and I get a lot of questions about why do we skip rows for, and I always say borders, and a lot of people don't know what I'm saying. It's because you guys aren't familiar with flood irrigation. So let me show you our borders.
See that right there? We come back and we do a second pass because it's above, you see, it's higher than the rest.
Thank you. 9700 right now. So we're having a problem. It was chopping corn yesterday and it kept throwing up the code for the brakes on the head. So it's got to be, usually the problem is from the harness that goes up to the cab. So right now I have down on the seat with the knives activated, so I get to go down there and wiggle some wires around, see if I can't get the head to stop. So hopefully it's something simple and we don't have to tear too much apart. All right, let's go down there. I think it did it to him one time yesterday, so maybe it was just a fluke. Hopefully that was it. So we got the knives all sharpened on this. Had to recalibrate the sharpening stone or the sensor. But it took about 120 passes to get them back to where they needed to be.